Robert, will you try to enjoy this?
Yes.
Imagine being in a tiny, quiet pocket of a park, right here in the middle of the busy, noisy East 50s. A park that's simple and pretty, with that waterfall on the wall that always makes me ache to be back at the Cape.
You are some piece of work, lady.
What I am is like this park here. Out of place.
Don't you have security cameras? Maybe they saw her.
The video's already being repeated.
This can't be happening. This cannot be happening.
It's Sarah's. I'm sorry, ma'am. It's evidence. It needs to be processed.
Where did you find it?
It was on a bench out front.
I don't understand.
You found it outside?
What about Sarah?
I'm sorry. She's not here. Security's turned the case over to the police. As of now, Sarah is a missing person.
She won't move.
What are you doing here?
I was worried about you.
She's still here. In this room. And I need that.
You tell him he is wrong.
Well, we don't know.
I know. A mother knows. Sarah is alive.
We've almost lost the heart to know how to keep our best in mind. Entertain you, celebrate you. I'll be back to frame you. I grow up, I'll be stable.
Don't wanna miss a thing.
I don't wanna miss a thing. Will you tell me everything that happened while I was sleeping?
Whew, well, that could take a minute. We need snacks.
Okay. It's okay.
No, no! I was there too. I knew the music box was dangerous. Put me in the coma.
No, Claudia, I will not let you or Micah or anyone else suffer. Listen to me. Thank you for today. If I only get one day, I am so, so glad I got this one.
I grow. I'll be stable.
Now get angry about something.
I'm fine.
Yes!
What?
No.
Yes. Oh my, this belongs to you now.
No. I told you. My strongest memories are of you and this guitar.
Sounds like you found your calling as a warehouse agent.
Yeah.
Hey, I was destined to be in a coma for the rest of my life, and somebody changed all that.
Who proves that beauty is but skin deep? And that a beast resides within us all.
Good for you. Cosmo's hanging right there. Get ready.
What am I supposed to do?
You're a foosball, right?
Yeah.
Ever been on the stage?
Not since I was 8.
What were you doing?
Sound of Music.
Huh. That'll help.
What happened to your leg?
I fell on some broken glass, which is why you're here. Get ready.
Yes, he's gonna fall in love with you all over again.
No, he can't.
Yes, he can. Come on, there's still plenty of him.
No, they have to get married.
What side are you on?
It's a secret. It's a big secret. I'm not supposed to tell anyone, so
spill
I can't.
It.
Caitlin's pregnant. I can't believe it. Caitlin lied about being pregnant to trick Tony into marrying her? Say it.
Yeah, it'll make you feel good.
Oh, I can't. I just can't. That big! Oh, yes. Can you sign in for me, please?
Sure.
So, do you have a date set?
June 8th.
You must be so excited.
No, actually, anxious, maybe.
Oh, then it's good that you're getting a prenup.
No.
You must have us confused. I'm Catherine Kanish, and this is my attorney, Craig Tebby.
Oh, my God, the switch. I am so embarrassed. Does that mean you might be available?
Dustin told me everything that happened the day you got shot. He was eaten up with the guilt. Changed after. I mean that. He was there for me.
How old is he? Your boy?
2. Travis Michael. He's a really fun kid. You'd like him. If he knew him.
Looks just like him.
All right, so the meeting of the Foxy Five will now come to order, and I will read the minutes from the last meeting. Woohoo!
I move the minutes are approved.
I second. Woohoo! All right, you're up, Lauren.
Ted and I are almost done planning the wedding. Berkshire's, snow, tons of alcohol, and the cutest ski hats with our wedding date embroidered on the pom-pom. You all better be there.
No. Wait, there is one thing. Boing!
Oh, my God!
Oh, yay.
Hallelujah! The last of the Foxy Five to get married.
Hey, hello? What about me?
Oh, my God, that's right. You're still not married.
It's harder than a matador coercing a bull to try to get you off of your rump. So single and attentive and attractive a man is everything a person could wish. But turning off the person is the act of a man who likes to pull the hooks out of fish.
Now, is anybody there?
Better immediately if you tell the truth. Right now.
Yesterday, I went to the guest house to see Abby.
Mm-hmm.
Austin was there, and they were arguing. I have never seen them like that. Abby tried to leave, and Austin started to shake her. And he was yelling at her and shaking her.
What did Abby do?
She hit him in the face. He was bleeding.
Then what happened?
I don't know. I left.
Why do I attract all the creeps? I dated this one guy, Craig, for like 2 months, and I thought like he was the one. And I called him up one night, his roommate answered the phone and told me that Craig had died. And I was like devastated. And me and the roommate, we scattered his ashes throughout Central Park, the whole thing. And I worked through the stages of grief with my life coach and a lot of random guys, and I was getting into acceptance when I ran into Craig at a bar. He had faked his own death.
Unbelievable.
I know, right? All I had to do was say he didn't want us to date anymore. I mean, it's not like I'm some psycho.
Looks.
Don't let them get to you. Tune them out. All of them. It's the only way to get through it.
Sweetie, he's your competition.
Awake. The patient's gonna be wide awake while we operate on his heart.
That is intense.
It is. It is intense. It's...
Is she your wife?
I don't know you well enough to have this conversation.
My mom manages a grocery store. And ever since I got engaged, she's been putting herself into serious debt. Over hand engraved place cards and chocolate fountains. It's her dream. My wedding is her dream. This is so important to her. This is what she's been living for since I can remember, since my dad left. My perfect night. So, I can do this. I can do this for her. Because she's done a lot for me. Whoa.
Get me a crash cart right now.
That's right. I mean, I had totally forgotten that they were casting it, and I was like, oh, that's right. I was like, what do you see me as? And I usually get Judy. Sorry. So I thought, what are you thinking of me as Judy? And she was like, no, actually, we're thinking of you as Christine. And my first reaction was, well, that's the girl that can't sing.
I'm a queen for you. I don't care if me dancing upon my
That's the most important thing. You instantly liked her.
And she's like her. And she's perfect with Tony Asbury.
That's always the bottom line thing, like you said. It's you gotta like them right away.
I made it to the final callbacks. Yes, for Christine. It went so amazing. Oh, sorry.
Right now, all of a sudden, my heart's starting to race again, thinking I'm going to be on the...
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm at theater. Talk about it.
This is too flimsy.
I watched everything that had dancing on it on television, especially... Oh, God. Every Sunday. It was...
Ed Sullivan!
Right! Yes. Ed Sullivan, every Sunday, like turns around to my house, selling,
lessons!
And he was a terrific salesman.
He put me up against the television set.
He turned me around,
picked up my foot and touched it to the back of my head and said, this little girl could be a star!
Mama? I got the job. Oh my God, I'm on Broadway? That's all I could say on that stage. I did it.